So it's really important. This is the original installation bulkhead. The furthest distance that we can go from this bulkhead without conflicting with the hatch opening is 9 inches. That's the absolute maximum for a long-legged paddler. The minimum is pretty well where the marking tab is initially, which is 3 inches away from the initial. So once again, the absolute maximum that we can go with this is 9.5 inches. This is only for really one particular purpose, and that's if we're going to move the foot braces forward, as initially indicated in the manual. This is set up for a paddler up to 6 feet tall. So we can keep the rudder, or the bulkhead panel, in essentially the same position as the marking tab. Right in here. But we will have to do a little bit of shape sanding to get it to fit in the right location. As you can see, it doesn't fit very well anymore. This bulkhead is installed after the deck is on, but it's best for us to do all of this now. Make sure that it fits well. For my peace of mind, I'm going to leave 3 inches after this side. I'm going to leave 3 inches. So this is my final location of this bulkhead, which is actually an inch and a half further ahead than this position here. It'll allow the paddler to extend their legs and be in a relaxed position. If we put the bulkhead right at the backs of this here, if we ever have to swap these out for the rudder control foot braces, we can't. We would have to cut the bulkhead out and move it. So it's best to just give ourselves a little bit of space now, and this will hardly affect your cockpit and bulkhead spacing. So once again, we are gonna have to trim this back. This is our new location, right here. Leave this piece here. Needs to be trimmed back. Piece here needs to be trimmed back. Three inches.
So now that we have this completed, we'll just set it aside, and when that deck and holder laminated, we'll be able to slide this under. There's likely going to be some sanding still required up here to get it in the right location.